Y'all, it's Vicky, the Divine Nomad, here on August 3rd doing the Baton Veda Challenge. Today we are talking about things that's in the news, but honestly, I don't watch the news and I don't read the news. But what I do have is I do Google Alerts for certain things that I'm interested in. So the one thing that I just recently read about was a gentleman by the name of Ari Goldman, who is a pretty well-known New York Times journalist who has recently decided that he is going to become, well, not recently, but he is a celloist of an orchestra in New York called the Late Starters Orchestra. Now, how did he get to this point? Basically, he was taking cello lessons probably in his mid-20s up to, I think he said he was about 35, and then he stopped due to work and family and life, which happens, right? So what happened was his young son decided to take up the cello. And no one really says in the article exactly how old he was when his young son took up the cello. But his son took up the cello and he decided that he wanted to play along with his son. So he actually asked if he could be a part of their orchestra. So he was noted as one of the oldest people to play in this youth orchestra. And he actually wrote an article about it years ago called Big Cello, Little Cello, or Little Cello, Big Cello. And what happened after that was he then was invited to be a part of the Late Starter Orchestra. And he has then so also started to write, he has written a book called the Late Starter Orchestra that kind of just talks about his becoming a late starter and basically the love of the music and everything that goes into learning music at an older age or whatever. But one of the things that I really like about the article is that he actually talks about how it's not about, the book isn't about the music, it's about life. It's about us who have always wanted to do something, but life has kind of stopped us from doing it due to all of the other things that we're interested in, or we just don't have enough time to be interested in it due to all of the things that has our attention in life. So I thought that was pretty interesting, because that is what happens to a lot of people, is life just really takes over and we don't have enough time, or we don't feel we have enough time to really be involved in those things that we are interested in. You know, it could be gardening, it could be learning a new language. And I feel like it's important that we continue to become life learners. And he kind of alludes to that when he talks about going to how his rabbi mentioned him and told him that he wanted to come in. He wanted him to speak to his class. And he said, well, I'm not playing the cello. And he says, no, I don't want you to play the cello. But he wanted him to inspire others to take up Judaism. He's Jewish. And he said basically something that the rabbi said that I really liked, is that it's not about being good at it, it's about just doing it. So whatever it is that you do, if it's something that you want to do, just do it. And you know, I think sometimes we get caught up in being the best at things, when if it makes us happy, we should definitely go after it. So that was the story that I wanted to share with you today, and I'd love to hear what you think about it, and how you feel about my storytelling. Anything that you can give me. Have a good day, and today is Sunday, so go out and do something fun or relax like I typically do. Have a great day. Bye-bye.